indication of a different range of material. SAC, as you all know, is the method of CAD-CAM, and CAD-CAM stands for computer-aided design, computer-aided manufacturer, where you can simply take an optical impression intraorally inside the patient's mouth. This intraoral optical impression will be converted into a screen, will be converted into a 3D software, where you can design your restorations with different applications. You can do an inlay, you can do an onlay, you can do elaborate veneer, you can do a bridge. You have the full setup here. You have the widest range of indications with the highest software of the machine available. You can do temporary bridge, you can do final bridge out of zirconia material, out of aluminum material, it's up to you. You can use lithium disilicates, whatever your clinical situation, whatever your clinical indication is, you can of course judge your material. Concerning the CAD part, which is computer-aided design, that you simply take an optical impression. This camera will transform the optical impression into the 3D software. And after you finish your design, simply you will press a button, and you will transform this design into a milling machine. This is the milling machine which is concerned with the CAM part, which is the computer-aided manufacturing. So you make your design, and you manufacture it with the same technology with the computer. This is basically what CAD-CAM stands for. Okay? I will give you just a short demo for a crown, and hopefully we have some time to make a very quick demo for a bridge, so you can understand what's going on with this software available here at your respective university. Simply, we will go here to administrate our case, add a new order. I will write it down for my name. It's demo. Patient. And I will administrate a new case. Okay? The software will ask me what I would like to do, whether I would like to do a single restoration, and he gives me four indications here, either a crown, if I want to make a crown, or an inlay, onlay, or a veneer, or an abutment. You know, lots of you are doing implants, and I believe putting an implant in the aesthetic zone is quite challenging. You need a little bit of more aesthetics, you need a little bit of experience to put an implant in the aesthetic zone. So this system can help you that you can construct an old ceramic abutment to be used later on for an old ceramic restoration without the risk of the metal display of your metal abutment with the conventional way. Okay? So I will choose a crown here, and I will simply choose my crown. My prep here is tooth number 16, as you can all see. I have a model here. I have two preps on the side. One for a bridge, for a three-unit bridge. Okay, on the left side of the patient, and one crown on the right side of the patient for the tooth number 16. Okay, so I will come here, I will choose a crown for tooth number 16, and the software will ask me which material to select. I believe this is a posterior crown, so we need more powerful restoration. We need a restoration accepting a flexural stress of 360 megapascal, which is the chemical name of the material. The chemical composition is lithium disilicate, and the commercial name is EmaxCAD. So we will choose EmaxCAD from a manufacturer called Evoclar Vivalent. We will choose here the IPS EmaxCAD to make our crown. Okay? Then we will confirm with OK. And now my crown is already administrated. Simply I will press Next. And this will be my optical impression. This is my active camera that I should introduce inside the patient mouse. Of course, these tips are autoclavable. These are autoclavable between the patients. And you can chemically wipe your camera before taking an optical impression between patients. I will hold my camera like a handpiece, and keeping my tip always to the distal part, I will just take my shot simply. I don't need to take a rubber-based impression. I don't need to take any kind of physical impressions. Now I will switch to the lower. I will switch to the lower jaw, and I will take my shot. The camera is automatic capturing camera. It's a shake-free camera. When I simply rest my hands on the occlusal surface of the knees of the patient, it takes the capture very precisely. Now I took the upper jaw and the lower jaw, and I will ask my patient to bite in eccentric occlusal relation, and I will take what we call a buckle shot. Simply this buckle shot just to determine my vertical dimension and to determine my bite for the patient. Okay? Now I'll press next. It's a very easy software. It's a very user-friendly software that you have five phases here. The first phase is the administration, where I administrated my case, my type of restoration, and I selected my material as well. Whether I will do whatever felspathic portion for the anterior region, showing a flexural strength of 120 megapascal, gaining the benefit of producing a highly aesthetic restoration, compromising lots of translucency and lots of cosmetic qualities. However, in the backside region, of course, I will use glass ceramic as well, but I will use a stronger material in order to withstand the masticatory forces from the patient apparatus, occlusal apparatus. I will simply ask the software to drag my buccal bite in order to stitch the upper and lower jaws together. Okay. I will drag them like this. So now I have my vertical dimension, I have my occlusion of the patient properly maintained. As I asked my patient to bite in this centric relation, and I was successfully transforming this from the patient mouse to the virtual 3D model. As you can see here with this software, it's a virtual 3D model where you can rotate your model, you can check your occlusal from the lingual side, you can check it from the buccal side. Another software that I would like to tell Dr. Amru for you, which is available from Sirona, it's called the Prep Check. And this Prep Check is mainly made for universities. It's not a very expensive software, it's a cheap software where you can buy it here, and simply you can take an optical impression for your prep, for your dummy heads, or inside your patient mouse, and the software will exactly tell you how accurate is your prep. Regarding the degree of tapering between the buccal and lingual walls, it's more or less an introductory software for the students, that you can determine how accurate is your preparation. And it will tell you how much is your occlusal clearance space. Is it enough or not, or do you need to modify it? Without any kind of manufacturing, without any kind of designing, you can design, of course, a demo program.
We have the unit down, but we don't have the software.
It's called Prep Check.
We have it.
It's available from Sirona.
We have it down.
Okay.
I will let you see.
Okay. Now I maintain my occlusal relation. The software will ask me to set my model axis, to set it in the normal plane. Like this. I simply press OK. You just have to follow the lines. You don't need to memorize anything. You don't need to save anything. It's just simply you should follow the next button. I will trim as if I'm doing ditching for my dies in order to check properly my finish line from my sides and to check my proximal contacts. This is what you do with the normal die removable die, with the normal ditching, in order to make a removable die so you can check the margins and check the proximal contacts. I will go to draw my margins. Simply, I will double click on my first of the line and double click at the very end of my line. And this will be my finish line of my prep. I think it's a very good prep. I can accentuate my margin in this way. I believe it's fine. Then I will determine my insertion axis. Some of us might do some sort of undercut, so they try to modify their insertion axis like this, and the software will alarm you if you did any sort of undercut. Of course, this will be an undercut area here. Okay? So this is, our preparation is not showing any kind of undercuts. With this common pass of insertion parallel to the long axis, simply I'll press OK and I'll press next. I will simply recalculate my restoration and the software will give me a proposal to do my crown. Okay? Of course, I can play a little bit with my design. I can add some material. I can increase my contacts. I can decrease my contacts. I can check my occlusion depending whatever I want. We have certain library here in order to check our occlusal anatomy. If the patient is an adult patient over 60 years of age, you of course know that the occlusal surface will differ from a youth patient. You will find lots of attrition on the cusp. So you can choose this if your patient is a little bit adult, and the software will give you more or less a flat morphology for older patients. Okay? If it's one of your colleagues, if he's a youth patient, if he's not an adult patient, you can simply choose a different morphology, which is the juvenile morphology for the youth patients, and you will find more anatomy and more occlusal morphology for this patient. Okay? You can modify the design, whatever you want. You can move your crown to the buccal, you can move it to the lingual, whatever directions you want to make. I believe this is a very quick way and a rapid way. My crown is fine, it needs to be a little bit rotated from this side. When I see from my proximal view, I can see a little bit of bulge here. So I will go to my move tool, and I can simply, as you can all see here, I can simply rotate my restoration like this, in a buccolingual direction. Okay, in order to make my design in a better way. I can simply rotate it clockwise or anti-clockwise, depending on whether I want to put my restoration. And not only this, I can, of course, move my restoration a little bit down, a little bit cervical, a little bit occlusal, but of course within limits, because I have an opposing arch here. And the software will allow me, and he will tell me, take care, you have premature contacts here. Okay? So I have to properly and be wisely enough know what I'm doing, whether I'm moving my crown in the right direction or not. Okay? You can, of course, do some modifications to your design. You can shape your restoration. You can increase your contacts, you can decrease your contacts. If you want to have a look for your contacts, you can simply trim it like here, and you will be very happy seeing your proximal contact from this side. And you will have, of course, need to do this. You will need to have a broad contact area in order not to have any kind of full impaction. Here the software tells you that you have a very high contact. This is too much stress on the contact. So you can, of course, decrease it a little bit and keep it into a lower direction. Of course, you know the position of the contacts in the posterior teeth, it's more or less in the mid area, not on the very high buccal area. Okay? You can enhance a little bit your cusps if you want to elongate your cusps, depending on your occlusal clearance. Of course, you will not need to do this. This will be fine. This here will be very okay for myself. Okay, let's go now for the second part of our construction technique, which is mainly concerned with the camper, which is computer-aided manufacturing. And I will put my block, insert it to the milling machine. And I will simply give an order to mill it.
The unit will tell you which size of block you have to put, okay? And you are going to select what kind of material. You are going to select what kind of material. We have different kind of materials according to the site of the restoration. For the anterior, there should be some kind of polychromatic, for example, for aesthetic. When you move a little posterior, we have more strands, so there is zirconium.